The months of preparation are finally over. Both sets of fans full of optimism as they look ahead to the new season. But who will come out on top today? Stay tuned, we'll have all the action for you live on EA TV. Hello and welcome to the Etihad Stadium. My name is Derek Ray, positioned here on the commentary gantry, and sitting next to me, ready to give you all the analysis, is Stuart Robson. And there are few more enjoyable days on the football calendar than opening day in the Premier League. It is Manchester City facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Well, thanks, Derek. What a start to the campaign this should be. And talking to some of the away fans, they believe this will be a good season for them. European qualification is certainly their expectation, starting with a victory here today.
And here's the Manchester City lineup. Ederson gets the nod in goal. Alexandra plays with Kyle Walker as fullbacks. Bernardo Silva plays alongside Kevin De Bruyne in the centre of midfield. And the main threat in attack today should be Erling Haaland. And a look at the lineup for Brighton.
Well, they're also playing in a 4-3-3 formation, but they play it in a slightly different way, particularly in the wide areas, where their fullbacks will get forward and rotate with the wingers at every opportunity.
And they kick off here. Estupiñán. St. Justa. Nketiah has it. Useful looking ball. Well, it nearly worked out. And a fine interception. Well, he's got plenty of space on the flank here. Suso. Could cross it in here. And the referee has pointed to the spot. A penalty it is, and a chance for them to forge ahead. And there it is. Perfectly executed. So the game back in business. City ahead here. Reina. Kefren Turam. Nketiah. Chance to do damage. Nelson. A really single-minded piece of defending to make sure nothing untoward happened. They've got it now. What can they do? Well, this could pose problems for the defenders. And nothing positive comes of it, unfortunately. Reina. Nketiah. Surely the equaliser. The save was a good one. And mopping up defensively. Bernardo Silva. De Bruyne. Haaland. Such an important goalkeeping intervention under pressure. In the right place to cut out the pass. Having won the ball back, they might be able to profit. Can he take advantage? Well, the keeper has outdone himself. Wonderful save. Put in by De Bruyne. Oh, he's left his marker for dead. And there it is, the goal they wanted for security. They lead by two now. They can breathe that bit more easily. So underway again, and a 2-0 advantage here. Good work to win it back high up the pitch. De Bruyne. Real chance. And a goal! They're running riot here, almost out of sight. Well, the action underway again. So comfortable for City, it's turning into a trouncing. Foden. Given away by City. Nketiah. Foden. Successfully cut out. Reina. De Bruyne. He quartered the attack illegally. Now perhaps a card is forthcoming. And that is goalkeeping of the very highest order. Corner coming up. Being pressed hard.
Well, those stats tell you everything. City have been excellent. And unless something changes, this could get embarrassing.
De Bruyne. Promising looking ball. Clean challenge. Good thing from his point of view. Nketiah.
Reina.
And he keeps going. Will it be? He knew he had to make the tackle and did. Counter-attacking, very much an option. So 1 minute of stoppage time. That's what the officials have said. Rodri. And here's Suso. De Bruyne. Can he finish this? Oh, it's a penalty. Just what they wanted to avoid, given the scoreline. And that is when you need your goalkeeper. And that is going to be all for the first 45 then, here at the Etihad Stadium. And off and running again, it really was spellbinding what we saw from City in the first half. So let's see how the second 45 plays out. And that's very good refereeing to let the play flow. Estupiñán. They've given it away. De Bruyne. Haaland. Now with Silva. De Bruyne. Another goal! The lead. And we're underway again. This game very much over as a contest. It's a perfect challenge. Haaland. This might be the perfect counter-attacking opportunity. But timely defending when it mattered. Well, we wondered if this deal was going to be done. In fact, it has now been done, Stuart.
Well, certainly a lot of focus on the boy over the last year or two, and he seems to have a bright future ahead of him. Hopefully it turns out to be a good move, and he can continue to develop his career.
Offside, a tight one. Foden. A meaty but fair challenge, and it will be a throw-in. Alexandro. Well, options at the back post here. Oh, back of the net! And a...
Oh, Father, tell me, do we get what we deserve? Oh, we get what we
After months of speculation, the deal is finally done, and we're just minutes away from seeing his debut. Can he live up to the hype? Hello, everyone. Great to have you with us. As you can see, we're at the Amex Stadium for this one. I'm Derek Ray, and ready with his tactics board alongside me is Stuart Robson, my commentary partner. And looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League coming right up. It's Brighton and Hove Albion up against Newcastle United.
Well, as far as Brighton are concerned, it was a good start to the season. They played with a lot of spirit and a fair amount of quality, but today will be just as tough for them.
And a look at the lineup for Brighton. So the starting 11 for Newcastle United. Nick Pope gets the nod between the posts. Kieran Trippier starts with Matt Target in the fullback positions. And the attack is led today by Alexander Isak.
Thank you, the Amex Stadium. Enjoy the game.
And this confrontation is underway. Isak. And return to Almiron. Nicely timed tackle. Pedro. Kefren Turam. And the keeper making sure there were no scraps for them to feed on. Well, John Stones makes his long-awaited debut here today. Stuart, what should we be looking out for?
Well, I think he's a really good defender. He makes timely interceptions, he makes the right decisions about when to squeeze up and when to drop off, and he's decent in the air. But he'll need to form an understanding with his teammates quickly, and that's not always easy.
This attack looks highly promising. Wonderful challenge, and a throw-in coming up. The cross is on. Very alert defending to cut off the supply. Well, for Brighton, certainly a difficult fixture last time out, and a draw against Manchester City. How might this one go, Stuart?
Yeah, there wasn't too much between them in that one-all draw. This will be much tougher, so I think they may lose this one today.
Well, he hit it with authority. Close. Isak. And this situation could be dangerous. That is a tackle and a half. Pedro. And the Seagulls losing the ball. Isak. And it's a quality pass. Well, I must say it did look so promising, but the flag is raised. Offside the verdict, Stuart.
Well, he's just too eager there. It's the right run, but he's made it too early.
Camavinga. A good and fair challenge. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? They need to get bodies back. Might take the lead. Quite simply, an opportunity wasted. Easy for the keeper. Eduardo Camavinga. Difficult to stop him. Can he finish? Oh, keeper dealt with it. Aware of the threat, solving the problem. Straightforward piece of goalkeeping. And he read it well defensively. Breaking at pace. Almiron. And attempting the through ball. Well, it didn't happen for them in attack. Promising sequence. A glorious chance. And he couldn't bag the first goal of the contest.
Well, I can't believe he's missed the target there. That's a poor finish.
Now they've lost it. Must take the lead here. And they have. You've got to say, it has been coming.
Well, look at this again. No real power, but great understanding of the situation. That's an excellent goal.
Well, the pressure has certainly been applied. Let's find out if Newcastle are feeling it. This could be interesting. Well, very close to half-time now, and it's a narrow lead for the home side. Stuart, how would you assess what you've seen?
Well, they've worked hard and played well to be in front here, but they now need to keep their focus as we approach half-time.
Oh, Stuart, they might be onto something here. Majestic piece of goalkeeping.
Well, he loves the big moments, doesn't he? And he's proved it again there. Great goalkeeping.
Well, the short corner routine. So underway again, following the goal that made things level. Oh, great attacking play. Well, he was able to make amends. Eduardo Camavinga. Can he find the right pass? There will be 1 minute added on at the end.
1 minute of added time.
Almiron. To really get at the opposition here. Joao Linton. Takes the shot. Well, the referee blows the whistle, and that is going to be all for the first 45 here at the Amex. Away they go again. Second half is underway here. Matt Target. Sven Botman. Target with it. It's with Joao Linton. No danger here as he runs at them. And they remain level.
Well, he just lacked composure there, didn't he? They should be ahead now.
Well, many have wondered if they would get it over the line in terms of the deal. They've succeeded, Stuart.
Yeah, I like the look of him. I think it's a good move for both him and the club. Let's hope he makes an impact fairly quickly.
And it crossed the byline, a goal kick as a result. Jesus Gallardo. On to Gilmore. Here's Gallardo. A very timely interception. And the counter-attack is on. Options available. All hands on deck. Able to skip past his man. And that's easy peasy for the keeper. Keeping the opposition at bay with that splendid challenge. So a half an hour remaining. Nicely timed tackle. And good use of advantage. The referee allowing play to continue. And don't forget, we have more Premier League action coming up for you on EA TV. It's Brighton and Hove Albion facing Crystal Palace. And with that, the attack fizzles out. Now, who can he play it to? There's a slide rule pass. And it's in! They're back in front. Stunning scenes here. And as they kick off again, 2-1 the current state of affairs. And they will be awarded a free kick for that. And he's clear his lines. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? Defensive resilience to shut them down. 20 minutes to go in this one. And they deal with the threat this time. And play halted, free kick given. Played in there. Well, he made great contact with that one, but the goalkeeper had his own ideas. So a personnel change then. Well, opting for the short corner. Dangerous looking attack. Fofana with it. Very quick thinking there. He could pick out a teammate. Well, the flag has gone up. It was really close. Intense pressure. So almost at full time, and the home side on course to eke out a narrow win. Stuart, your thoughts?
Well, they've certainly controlled the tempo of the game, and just about...
Oh, Stuart, opportunity here! And a goal! They lead by two now, and that allows them to breathe a bit more easily.
Well, here's the replay. He does well to find that bit of space in the box, and then he shows a lot of composure to finish it off. That's a good goal.
So back underway at 3-1. And he's got the beating of his opponent. Isak. Now they stopped them in their tracks. Wilson. And it's with Isak. It's still alive. Well, threat over for now. And the defender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. They've decided that now is the time to go to the bench. And he did so well to move across and deal with the danger. And now the delivery. Sound piece of goalkeeping. No mistake by the keeper. Isak. And they produce the arrears. You never know. They still believe in themselves. 3-2 it is. Who would have predicted that before a ball was kicked? There will be 3 minutes added on at the end.
Substitution for Brighton.
And ties for goal. Oh, really? really good reflexes and danger averted. Time is not on the side. This corner could help the prospects as they look for an equaliser. And caught by the keeper.
3 minutes of added time.
And there goes the final whistle. We can call this a seagull's success story. 3 points for Brighton. How would you sum it up?
Well, Derek, I think they have to be happy with their display today. They were dangerous with the ball and they defended well enough. It's a great start for them.
And in the final analysis, a really positive performance from this man, Stuart.
Well, I have to say, that was impressive. Not just his goals, but his all-round play. He was excellent.
Just a moment of your time. Yeah, no further questions, thanks.
Well, thank you all for joining us. All right, we'll take questions now. That's all we have time for today.
press people button. Nobody chat come face me with some. Like for me, I have me a fin and me some. Then I feel so forget the next dozen fool. Press me up, press people button. Nobody chat come face me with some. Like for me, I have me a fin and me some. Then I feel so forget the next dozen fool. Anytime you're ready, bring it. Start war. See who love is for the top up on the
style. Style is the bomb, diggy bomb, the dang, the dang, diggy diggy. A room boy no play with the bomb, the dang, diggy diggy. My style is the bomb, the dang, diggy diggy. A room boy no play with the bomb, the dang, diggy diggy.
Sit down and I watch your man a live. Watch your man a own a who a roll big. Sit down and I plan for comfort.
Well, what a game we have in store for you today. The hype has been building all week and the fans are pouring into the stadium. The tension palpable. Stay tuned. We'll have all the action for you live here on EA TV. Hello from a stadium with a reputation for producing one of the liveliest atmospheres in the English game. We're in South London at Selhurst Park. My name is Derek Ray, excited to be bringing you match commentary. And alongside me, my broadcasting partner, Stuart Robson. I'm looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League coming right up. It's Crystal Palace facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Well, Derek, I have to say, I've been really impressed with Brighton in their first couple of games. A win, a draw, and most importantly, a couple of excellent performances. Now they need to build on that and get something from this game here today.
And here's the Palace 11.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how the wingers play today. Will they stay high and wide? Will they come in field and support the centre forward? And how deep will they come out of possession? They're going to be key to this formation.
And a look at the lineup for Brighton.
Well, they're also playing in a 4-3-3 formation, but they play it in a slightly different way, particularly in the wide areas, where their fullbacks will get forward and rotate with the wingers at every opportunity.
Thank you, Selhurst Park. Enjoy the game.
Confrontation is underway. And do they mean business on this occasion? The supporters want to see him have a go. Body in the way. Must score! And a goal! An early boost for them. The first goal of the game. They're off and running. And the ball moving again. What sort of response will we see from them now? Lamptey. St. Justa. Might really be able to trouble them here. A disappointing end to the move. Camavinga trying his luck from long range. Odson Edouard. Oh, he looks threatening. Element of risk there, but he's won the ball. Camavinga. A pretty ordinary challenge. Might be a chance here. And a goal! Real excitement here. The equaliser. So back underway following the equaliser. Anderson. Wilfried Zaha. And Palace moving the ball with purpose. Nkessia. Must be a goal here, giving his team precisely what they were looking for. Now he deserves to celebrate it. So back underway at 2-1. Tight contest here. Toussaint. Doucouré. Toussaint. It's still there for him. Strength and control, a big part of his game. And players waiting in the centre. So a corner here. Favouring the short one. Ezzy. Oh, great defending.
Well, it's been difficult for Brighton to get too much of the ball so far, but they've certainly shown an ability to counter-attack when they win it back. I expect more of the same. I think it's been a really good performance from them so far.
And having to soak up a bit of pressure again here. Poor attempt at a pass, really. Toussaint. Now showing excellent vision. Such an important goalkeeping intervention under pressure. Camavinga. Giovanni Reina. Nelson. Well, this could be productive. And a goal! They're going to take some stopping now. Two in front here.
Well, here it is again. He goes past his marker so easily with just a drop of the shoulder. And then what a strike. That's hit with such ferocity. Certainly no stopping that. That's a great goal.
So on with the action. And 3-1 the scoreline at the moment. Wilfried Zaha. A really committed challenge, and it's gone out for a throw-in. He has time to play it over, and making the run to the inside. Takes aim! Can they stop it going in? Well, they can bring it out now. Well, that's how to do it, inside your own penalty area. And teammates around him. There to take it away. And that is going to be all for the first 45 here at Selhurst Park. Well, quite simply, he hasn't been able to make his mark in attack in this game, Stuart.
Well, it's not been one of his best displays, Derek, has it? He really hasn't been able to affect the game here. Unless he starts getting on the ball, they're going to struggle to get back into this one.
Well, underway once more, and it's going to be fascinating to see what developments occur in the second half. And with that, the attack fizzles out. Reina. Oh, he looks threatening. Now, let's see what they can do here. Well, nothing comes of it. It looked promising. Bodies forward and the break looks on. Odson Edouard.
Well, good hands there from the keeper.
A really top-notch piece of defending. Could reduce the deficit. There it is! A goal to reduce the arrears and give them hope that they can turn this round. 3-2 it is. Who would have predicted that before a ball was kicked? He read the situation defensively and did his job. Can they do something positive on the counter-attack? Well, that's wonderful attacking play. Oh, a perfectly timed pass. Well, it looked like it might lead to something very positive indeed, but a useful interception. Well, many have wondered if they would get it over the line in terms of the deal. They've succeeded, Stuart.
Well, he's a great talent. Hopefully this move will see him play at his best week in, week out. It's a really good move for everybody.
Oh, poor from the keeper. Big chance. Oh, wonderful goalkeeping.
Well, you have to say, from that sort of distance, that's a wonderful save.
And a substitution in the offing. It's in. They're looking really relaxed and confident and not giving the opposition much of a look in.
Well, here it is again. And you have to say, it's the perfect delivery into the danger area. And it's a comfortable finish in the end, which is made to look so easy. It's a lovely goal.
So the current scoreline, 4-2. Well, tremendous block. Zaha. Opportunity for them to get back into the game. A goal! That's two for him today. They simply can't stop him. No wonder he's celebrating.
Well, let's have another look. It's a wonderful bit of interplay to start the move off. And when he gets onto it, he decides to go for power. It's a really emphatic finish, which gives the keeper no chance.
Well, Crystal Palace just one behind now. And you sense, don't you, that the momentum may be with them. Eduardo Camavinga. Right, I think we better go to Alex Scott for an update, because I believe Alex has been a goal at the London Stadium.
It's a goal for Bournemouth. They're the first on the score sheet here with 74 minutes played.
Alex keeping us right up to date. Oh, he's given the ball away unnecessarily. And into the last 15 minutes of action. And we very much hope you'll join us for more live Premier League action on EA TV. It's Crystal Palace facing Manchester City. We're getting right on top of their opponents and winning it back. Well, let's see what they have in store for them on the break. Will it be sufficiently imaginative? Surely! Really good diving stop to make sure the threat came to nothing. If they can score again from this corner, it probably would be the end of the story. Toussaint.
Well, I have to say, these fans have been excellent. They still believe they're going to get back into this.
Well, do they have a goal in their future? They're giving it a go. Well, nothing comes of it. It looked promising. And just 5 minutes remaining. Tyrick Mitchell. Eberechi Eze on the ball. And with that, the attack fizzles out. And fed forwards. That's well blocked. With a touch off the defender, last of all. So a corner. And they have elected to go to the bench at this stage of the game. It's not a particularly good corner there. Nelson. Oh, the goalkeeper did well to hang on to that one. And that is going to do it. The referee blows for full time. Brighton and Hove Albion have picked up maximum points. How would you sum it up?
Well, it's been a very good start for them, and today they showed what a well-organised side they are. Can they just keep it going now? That's the big question. They certainly look confident.
Well, there's a good reason why we're highlighting him. Really dominant in attack in this game, Stuart. The supporters want to see him have a go. Body in the way. Must score! And a goal! An early boost for them.